Well, hello guys. This is part two. We're supposed to go to the gas station or something like that. Let's see. Oh my god. I think I need to listen to that radio thing, I guess, again. Something like that. Let's see. This game feels super unsettling. Okay. Okay. This is how to dodge. Okay, why are you tired, bro? Only 3 cells? I think there are more cells, right? Oh, okay, three only, I guess. Jesus, dude, this is how my parents went to school, probably. Run! Shit, no. Bro, my God. Picked up batteries, picked up revolver ammo. Where is this stupid gas station, dude? God, I'm fucking. I don't know if I can say afford. Let's see. Can I duck? Can I sneak? I don't think I can, I guess. Let's go. That's how I came. Dude, what the? Safe haven. Yeah, this is safe haven, of course. I came from here. Dodge. I have to know how to, dodge properly. Thank you. Oh, run, run, run. Shit. Can't even fucking jump. So how do I escape? Can I go like this? Oh my god, there are stones. Okay. Oh God, thank God.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide.
Okay.
If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please. Stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. Night springs.
What the heck is this? So basically, man, I don't know quantum physics, but quantum mechanics. Anyway. Okay, can I pick anything else? That's it, right? 9 rounds. God damn it, is somebody coming? Checkpoint. Definitely some stupid boss. This is blast fight.
Thank you.
Dude, how do I kill that guy?
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Oh my god. Finally, I killed this guy. I mean, it's not that difficult. But I got it. Yes, awesome. I picked it up, okay. Dude, what's the, where are they? But that is the gas station. But the doors are opening.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Mm.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. Amazing. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Thank God.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Okay. Let's read the manuscript. Throw some mushrooms.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. Mm-hmm. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
My God, dude, what's going on?
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen. I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wade.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Colored clown, they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right.
All right.
I close my eyes, then I drift away into the magic night. I softly say a silent prayer.
Did something happen? Okay. So don't skip.
Then I fall asleep to dream my dreams of you. In dreams I walk with you, in dreams I talk to you, in dreams you're mine,
Okay, I'm skipping it.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
So to take in. Let's go episode 2. At my seat 3 years ago.
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Switch to coffee maker.
Hey, handsome. This is gonna be a long night, but these shots are turning out great.
I guess you're gonna need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Coffee? Is this window or this is paintings?
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
No to Alice.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
All right. Examine cover mock-ups. You mean the photograph? Okay, whatever. How do I examine?
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine. Just get the lights back on. Now, please.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay.
I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No, no. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Brick falls.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
I believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Alice was missing.
Was
I needed
Weaver.
Help to find
I
her.
You can call
I wasn't
her
ready to leave.
Eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
What happened?
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brake float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stuckey. Jane's out.
Manuscript. I don't know what this manuscript is, but okay.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Where is she? Cat? Missing, have you seen this man? Okay. Should Bob Rose answer? What about the cat?
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd locked me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal.
Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
I thought he quit drinking for good.
I couldn't go anywhere yet. I had to play along with the caller. Alice's life was at stake.
You can get to the back lot through that door and down the corridor, Mr. Wake.
Hey! Hey! I need more light in. Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on! The deputies, they don't understand. They won't.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the Sheriff's Department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting that the big day's almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car. Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
The heck is going on? He's sleeping, this dude is sleeping.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at their farm.
Indeed. All we can do is to slow down the progress of their dementia.
Okay.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh! Hey! Oh my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him!
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Wait here.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky. Max is still groggy from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just yet. The form's on the desk across from the mammoth skeleton. Okay, boy. We're almost done here.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing, listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
Look, Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit, period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on. I mean, okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Audio is like go fine. We'll stop here and we will continue it part 3, okay?